Very good morning, students. For this session, I am going to solve one more problem from the chapter orthographic projection. Let me, sir, read out the question first. What are the views which I need to draw from the given pictorial view? Draw the top, front, and side views of the machine element given here. Fine. So, just before proceed to draw the views, all the three views, one must see the direction of view from where I need to start the front view. So this denotes, this arrow denotes the direction of view. So front view should be drawn looking at this direction. Fine. Since the front view is here, then left side, so I need to bifurcate the board in a manner to cover all the three views. Since it is a left side view, as far as the first angle projection is concerned, looking at left of this particular object, I need to draw the right side of the front view. So the view should, the side view should come in the right hand side of the front view. So the space has been allocated. Now I need to start the drawing from the front view looking at this direction. So now this particular diagram or drawing is an isometric projection, isn't it? It's a 30 angle drawing. The chapter which we are here is orthographic projection, which is nothing but right angle drawing, right? So I need to rotate this object, and this object should be perpendicular to me so that I can view the front view. So when I view it from this direction of the pictorial view, I could see the lower portion here, right? This lower portion, this arm would be visible, isn't it? Then this circular portion, this portion would be visible. Just follow how I am going to draw this diagram. First, the dimension of this particular base is 60 length and the height of 20 mm. You take 2H pencil because we are going to draw the freehand sketching. So the base is 60 mm. The base is 60 mm. So this is 60 mm and the height is 20. The height is 20. I have drawn this rectangle, but look at the base, there is a groove has been cut. So of height 10 mm, of size 40 mm. So 60 minus 40, it is 20. So either side 10 mm. Either side 10 mm. So 10 mm from here and 10 mm from here. Then the height of this particular goo is 10 mm. So total it is 20, then half of this one. Right, the base has been drawn here. Now I need to draw this particular portion. There's a verb, I need to draw it, for which I need to observe how this can be drawn. Look at here, 70 is the height of this particular arm. From this above the base to the top, it is 70 mm. And where it ends, look at here, from the left extreme to here, it is 70. So the height, the total height is 70 mm from the base. The base is 20 mm. So from the base, it is 70. From this portion, it is 70 minus 20. Therefore, this could be 50 mm above this platform. So take 50 mm from here. Draw a small construction line. and from there 70 mm. From there 70 mm. This total is 60. Therefore, 70 should come more than this base. Right. Now, I need to join from this point to this point. So this is the point, and this is the point. So now draw a line connecting both the points. Right. So up to here, I have drawn. Now, this extended portion I need to cover it up. So for which, observe the drawing. From here, from this edge to the center, it is 40 mm. From here to the center, it is 40 mm. From here to the center is 40 mm. This is the center. How the center should be marked? With long line dot long line dot long line, long line, right? So this represents the center of the circle or the axis of the circle, right? So now look at here. When you just look at the cylinder from this direction, I could see a rectangle box, and the height of this is 30 mm, and up to here it is dia 40. Therefore, this should be 40 and this should be 30. So total it is 40. So in the right hand side it would be 20 mm, and for left hand side it would be 20. So draw a thin line. Right. Now this with this the height is 30. So total height is 30 mm, isn't it? Right. So the height is 30 mm. From here, take 30, close the box. So this is not required because up to here only the object is there. That machine element is up to here only, right? So this I have drawn. Now look at here where it ends. It ends at the circumference of the circle. What would be the distance from here to here? This from here to the center it is 40, and from here to here it is 20 because it's a dia 40. Therefore, 20 on the left hand side and 20 in the right hand side. So from 20. So if it is 20 from the center, naturally from this verb it should be 20. From here it is 20. Right. Draw a line. Right. Now let me just connect here. Look at this arm, where it ends, that means where it terminates. It on the base of the particular machine element, it ends at the base of the here. If the arm ends here, it would have been, the line could have been ended here, but this denotes this particular arm, this portion extended till the base of the particular machine element. So let me just draw. So line connecting this one, right? Because this should be 20 and this should be 20, because in total it is 40 at the center. So if it is 20, then balance is 20. It terminates at 20 from the center or from the arm where it ends, right? Anything else I could see here? This particular square, this symbol represents square, isn't it? This symbol represents pi, that is diameter. This R represents radius. Here it is this shape, therefore square of 15, right? This particular, but when I just look at from this direction, I can't see this. This is just behind this object. That means it is invisible to me when I look at from this direction. How it is positioned? Look at here, it is square, isn't it? The distance is given here. From here it is 20. See, as far as this wave is concerned, we need not to worry about the distance from this platform because it is invisible. The total dimension is 15 because it is a square. So from the center, so total it is 60. So 30 could be somewhere here, right? This hole is throughout. When you could see this kind of termination, that means this hole, the square hole, is a through hole. Otherwise, it would have been specified at a depth of so much mm. This particular hole is there. Whereas in this particular diagram, it is not specified. Therefore, it is a through hole. So from center, total it is 15. Therefore, 7.5 in the right hand side and 7.5 in the left hand side, isn't it? So this is invisible. So dotted line. So it is dotted line. Look at this extended portion. There is one circle within the cylinder, right? Which I can't see it. So that would be an invisible one that is hidden. What is the size of this hole? The circle is 26, dia 26. Therefore, 13 in the right hand direction and 13 in the left hand side direction. So draw the dotted line. Right? Before I proceed to the next view, let me just go through each and every parts of this machine element. Anything is missed out. This particular portion has been captured, well and good, and this arm has been captured, fine. Then this extended portion, that is a cylinder which has been captured, and this circle is invisible within the cylinder which I captured here, and there is one square hole, there is a through hole on the base above this groove which I captured here, isn't it? Right. Now I need to draw the top view. Top view is nothing but the plan. So looking at the top of the object, and the object should be perpendicular to me because this particular chapter is orthographic projection. So the object should be always perpendicular to the observer. Now the observer is me. So I'm just looking at the top of this particular object. What are the things I could see? I could see this entire platform, isn't it? The entire platform I could see, and two square hole is visible. Both are visible, and this particular arm is visible when I look at from the top, and this extended portion is visible, and this circle is visible, and this cylinder is also visible. Fine. Just observe how I am going to proceed for the plan or the top view. First, what I have to do is all the visible or invisible thing, I need to project it to the top view. Let me just project it. Visible and invisible, everything I need to project towards the top view. Visible, invisible, everything allowed to project it towards down to draw the top view of this machine element. Right. So what would be the width of this object? It is 90, right? So 90. Length is 60 and the extended portion. Length has been obtained from the front view. Now the width is 90. So leave 20 mm from this front view, right? And from here it is 90, right? This is the rectangle box has been constructed. So within the rectangle box only, I have to draw the plan of this particular machine element. How to proceed? Yeah, first let me just draw the total platform of length 60 mm, right? Where is the platform? The platform is here. So this is the platform. Got it? Right. Now, within this, the square hole is there of dia 15. Right. Now, how it is positioned? From the corner, it is 20 mm. From the corner, it is 20 mm. So, draw a thin line. Similarly, the other side also, because it's a symmetrical, therefore, it's a mirror image of this particular hole. Therefore, this is also 20 mm from here. Right? Now, it is total, how it is placed? So, it's a square 15. Right? Square 15. From here it is 30. From here it is 30. And I need to draw the square of 15 mm. So this 30. So right, this, let me just draw the center of this one. So now 15 totality. So therefore here it would be 7.5. Here it is 7.5. And the center 7.5 here. And 7.5 here. Is it okay? Let me just draw the square of 15. Similarly, same thing I need to repeat for this particular hole, that is a square hole of 15. So let me just extend this center here, right? This totality is 15, 7.5 in the left hand side, 7.5 in the right hand side of from the center. So 7.5 here, 7.5 here. Let me draw the square of 15. Now, the base is over. The base consists of two square hole of 15 mm. This has been over. Now, let me just move to the arm, extend this arm, where it ends. It ends at this level, right, of thickness 20 mm, of thickness 20 mm. How it is placed? It is in the center. So from the center, it is 10 mm in the left hand side, 10 mm the right hand side. Total, it is 90 mm. From this 90, let me just draw the center line. This is the center of 90, that is 45 mm. So the arm width is, or thickness is 20 mm. So 10 on the above and 10 below. Where it ends up to here. So let me just draw from here. It ends here, 20. So total it is 20, 10 mm above the center and 10 mm below the center. So now it's over. When you just look at from the top, there is a edge. So this edge is visible. This edge is visible. Now, this circle is visible. And this almost 80% of the circle is visible here, right? Now, this is a center. Let me just extend the center here. That is the axis. Now, the total, internal dia is 26, which I have extended here. So, 26. So here it is 13, in the left hand side it is 13, therefore above is also 13 and below is also 13. With free hand, I have to draw a smooth circle of dia 26. So circle has been drawn and this external circle also visible of dia 40, which I have the projector been here. From the center it is 20, from here in total it is 40, therefore above it is 20 and below it is 20. With free hand, let me just draw a smooth circle without using any instruments, because the one which I am drawing is a freehand sketching. So therefore,
other than pencil and eraser
I should not use any other instrument or drafting tools. This has been over. Now look at this circle, which is not a full circle, it's a incomplete circle, right? So there is a extended portion of 20 mm. Let me just extend this and erase this off. Now when I look at from the top, I could see almost 70 to 80% of the circle which I captured here, right? So anything else is visible when I look at from the top? This platform I have drawn, these two square holes which I captured, this arm has been captured, and this particular portion has been captured, and two circles which have been captured. Anything else is visible? No. Whatever the visible outlines, that means the object line, have been constructed here. Now this particular portion is invisible, which is, look at here, this groove, when I look at from the top, it won't be visible for me. So it is an invisible edges, so which I need to capture it in the front view. That is, this groove is for the entire width of the particular machine element. So this is the groove, right? So I need to draw dotted line for this. So the invisible things need to be captured with hidden line, there is a dotted line. Fine. So I'm not going to darken all the object, I mean visible or object line. Now once I complete all the three views, then only I am going to construct all the visible or object lines. Now next is the side view. So for which, for an example, I just drawn here a small square, and passing through the corner I have drawn a line as incline, which is approximately equal to 45 degree, right? So now extend all the visible and invisible edges till it touches the inclined line of 45. Extend all the visible and invisible edges, so the circle, and since it is 13, this is 10, so therefore it should be below this, and below this, and this circle, sorry, so it should be parallel to each other, right? And for this square, extend this, and for this square, extend it, and the base, you extend it, right? Now I need to draw a vertical line. This is a projection, vertically upwards, vertically upwards. So look at here, it should be a 90 degree, it should be 90 degree, right? So project all the lines vertically upwards. It should be thin line, so don't change the grade of your pencil. The grade of the pencil should be 2H only. Till my further instruction, you should not change your pencil's grade, right? So now I'll have to draw the horizontal line from the front view. So visible and invisible edges. So from the groove, right? It may be confusing, but once you know that how this line has been projected, easily you can plot the side view here, right? Now since it is a left side view, I need to capture the side view on the right side of the front view. Now I'm just going to look at this object from here, assuming this side is perpendicular to me, that is orthogonally to the observer, right? So when I look at from here, this particular base is visible of height 20 mm and the width is 90 mm, right? So this has already been extended, so 90 is here, so this is the periphery and this total height is 20, so this could be the box. So this is the base of the machine element. This is the base of the machine element. Now let me just move to this arm, right, of 20 mm. Look at here, this is 20, this one and this one, up to where it is been projected, up to the top, up to the top. So here you can't see anything, but in the behind, this particular extended portion is touching the base of this machine element. Therefore this could be invisible to the observer. This is invisible and balance, everything is visible, right? Now two portion I have completed, the base I have drawn and the extended portion I have drawn, and this is only 20 mm, whereas the cylinder size is 40 mm, so it would be bigger than the arm. Therefore that particular cylinder would be visible either side 20 mm. So center, let me just extend this, so this is the center, so center needs to be denoted with long line dash, long line, right? That's the axis of this one, and where the portion is from here, so this is the line and it is extended here. Be careful while plotting it, right? And where the other end, it comes here, comes here and here. So this portion is the cylinder. This portion is the cylinder. Now this circle is invisible to me because when I look at from here, I could see the periphery of the cylinder, but this circle would be invisible to me. So that circle would be here, that is, that should be denoted with dotted line. And where the other side, this is the other side of the, there is a total diameter is 26, right? When I look at from here, this particular grooved portion cannot be seen when I look at from here, so that would be invisible, isn't it, for the total width of 90 mm. Where it is, here it is, so total 90 mm, it is invisible. Fine. Now both the square hole, the through hole of 15 mm is invisible, right? So where the hole is, it comes here, right? This one is invisible and comes here. Yeah, it is, it is invisible. And the other side, it comes here, right? This is invisible and the other end would be here. Fine. Now change the pencil from 2H to HR HP. Now I am going to construct the object line or the outlines here, right? So with HR HP pencil, draw the dark lines, that means object lines. Fine. This is the cylinder, that is the extended portion of the machine element which I captured here. This is the internal cylinder of dia 26, which is invisible, therefore I have captured with dotted line. Now the arm, there is a this particular portion, I am drawing it here. This terminates at the base of the machine element. This is a groove, right? So, and this is the base. The inverted C is nothing but base of the, and this is the dotted line. What it represents? It represents the square hole of 15 mm, right? Now I have captured the front view. Now let me just darken all the outline or visible edges of the plan or the top view. First, what you have to do is you have to draw the boundary. So the boundary always visible. Therefore, just construct the boundary here. This is top view. So this particular should be dotted boundary of the platform or the base has been drawn. Now this arm I need to draw from the left extreme. It is there. So from the extreme till this edge, it is visible. Right now, this particular portion is visible. Draw it dark. Now the cylinder, internal circle is also visible, and it is not a full circle. So let me just draw that too. And next comes the full circle of diameter 26. Fine. Let me just move to the side view, right? So first the base. So base has been extended here. So this is the base. So throughout it is visible of height 20 and width is 90. So this is total 90 is the width and height is 20 mm. Don't overdraw. Though it is a freehand sketching, but draw as much as straight possible, right? This is over. Now this particular portion is here, isn't it? So this 20 mm is visible. 20 mm is visible. Now the cylinder of height 30 mm and dia 40. So that is visible. Right. Now this particular circle, which is invisible, so it should be drawn as dotted line. Fine. Now this particular groove is invisible, which I captured here with dotted line, right? Rest all the lines. If it is confusing, then better it to erase that off so that the drawing would be neat and legible, right? This arm is invisible, so therefore draw dotted line. And this is the square hole of 15, so which I captured here. So with this, I have completed all the three views of this machine element. Now I need to capture the dimensioning part. Before that, let me just give the naming for all the three views here. So this, you know, there's a guideline of 5 mm height. There's a front view or elevation. So the other name of front view is elevation. So this is front view, and this is the left side view. So if you want, you can just mention side view itself, or else you can mention that as left side view. Side view. And as far as this view is concerned, it is a plan or top view. This is a plan or top view. Right. Now I am going to give the dimensioning for the particular machine element. Starts with the this particular view, that is a front view. Total it is 40. This is 40 mm. Over the dimensioning line, you should write it 40, and the entire length of this particular base is 60. So this is 60. So always the smaller dimension should be closer to the object, and the bigger one should be away from the object. Right. Next, this particular height is 20 mm. The base height is 20 mm. Right. This is 20. Fine. Then the height of this arm is 70 mm from the base. From the base. It is 70. And look at here. From this end to this edge, it is 70, which I need to capture it in the front view itself. Up to here, it is 70. Then from this edge to the center of that cylinder is 40 mm. Extend it. Now draw the arrow. 40. Anything else which I can capture here? So this 60, 40 has been captured. This 10, I need to capture it, for which I'll have to just extend. So it should be away from the object, therefore I'm just extending here. This should be 10 mm height, right? I have captured. Now let me just move to the top view, where I could construct, give the maximum dimensioning here. So what I can mention is this 90 I need to capture, this 20 I need to capture, dia 15 I need to capture. Just observe it. So from here it is 20. This is 20 mm. Isn't it? Yeah, this is 20. And the size of the hole is 15, which let me just extend here and mention this as square 15. This simple, so that the size of this particular object, that is the shape, is square, which I captured here. The entire length is 90. In addition to this, this particular extended arm is 20 mm, which let me just capture it here as 20. The overall width of this machine element is 90. Extend this. This in totality it is 90 mm. Fine. That has been captured. Now let me just give the dimensioning for the cylinder and internal circle here, for which let me draw the leader line by mentioning the boundaries here. Dia 26. Dia represents, that the pi represents the dia of the circle, which I have mentioned, right? Now, passing through the center, one more leader line, marking the boundaries here, dia 40. Fine. As much as information I have captured here, let me move to the side view. So now in the side view, I need to mention the height of the cylinder. The height of the cylinder is 30 mm. Anything else can be captured in the side view? Anything else missed out? Look at the given isometric drawing. If anything missed out, which can be captured in the side view? See, since I have captured all the height, distance, the circle diameter, everything, therefore I haven't missed out anything in the given diagram. Right, now whatever dimensioning I mention here, the unit of dimension is in mm. Therefore I need to mention it here in the diagram, for which draw a guideline of 5 mm height and mention all dimensions are in mm. All dimensions are in mm. In mm. Right, then what about the scale? I haven't changed any of the, or I haven't used any of the scaling. That means true scale, or sorry, the reduced scale or entire scale. Whatever the dimension is, as it is, I have mentioned here. Therefore, it is a true scale. So the scale should be 1:1. As being true scale, I need to specify here 1:1. Fine. So with this, I have completed the required views, front, top, and side views of this particular machine element. Thank you.